Today we're going to be talking about the Burkert Communicator and how to connect the Burkert devices onto the computer and the Burkert Communicator software using Burkert connection kits. Of the connection kits, we have two options, Burkert Buskit 1 and Burkert Buskit 2. Buskit 1 is the set that contains all of the cables and accessories necessary to get your devices online and view the process and diagnostic data. Inside Buskit 1, we'll run through what we have quickly. We have the female M12 to mini USB cable with a barrel jack for power. We have a male to male M12 adapter. We have the all important bus stick, which will take our devices and do the can open to USB conversion. We have a magnet tool for disassembling our flow wave module devices, such as the display and front cover. We have the M12 to micro USB for non-bus devices such as analog and field bus. We have the flying leads to M12 for devices with terminals such as our ME43 and 8652 valve island, a Y connector to daisy chain and break into the network. And we also have a range of power adapters for the different regions. Inside Buskit 2, we have a much more slimmed down offering of the cables in Buskit 1. We have the same M12 to mini USB connector with barrel jack power lead. We have the micro USB to M12 connector, and we also have that all important bus stick. Connecting to the devices, there are a number of interfaces that we can use. On analog and field bus devices, we have a micro USB service port. Some devices have this under a cover. Other devices have this on the top of the control head, but the interface will always be the same. To connect to these devices, we will use the M12 to micro USB cable. For devices with terminal strips, like our ME43 and 8652, it's important to use the flying lead to M12 cable to come into the terminal block and connect this to your wider bus network or to a Burkert Communicator tool. Native bus devices will have a built-in M12 port that you will use the standard M12 to mini USB cable to connect. Once the cables are connected, you'll connect the other end of the mini USB port to the USB stick, which will connect to the PC so that you can connect to the Burkert Communicator. A fully assembled cable may look something like this from start to finish. Once the devices are powered and cabled together, we can connect them to the computer to view in Burkert Communicator. There are a few ways to connect to the devices in Communicator, but today we will just focus on using the bus stick. To connect to the bus stick, we can select File, Add Interface, the Add Interface shortcut in the menu, or the New Project button. Let's go ahead and add the interface, being sure to use the USB bus stick option. The bus stick is not found, as I have not yet connected it to my computer. When I plug this in, we see that the bus stick is then detected. Ensure that the baud rate is set to 500 kilobits, as this is the default for the devices out of the factory. Some advanced options can be seen in the dropdown. For now, ensure that these boxes are unchecked and click Finish. When trying to search for the devices, we see the communicator has found an error. There are a couple of reasons for this, possibly no devices connected, the wrong baud rate, or no terminating resistors in the network. Be sure to check all of these factors. For now, I can see I have a loose cable. Once I connect this, communicator will search for the devices one by one, and they will appear in communicator. We can look at the entire network by clicking on the bus interface. Here, we see an overview of all the devices of the network. From Communicator, there are many functions that can be performed, such as firmware updates and seeing what error messages a device has. We can select a device from the device tree on the left-hand side of the screen to view its process data. From this screen, we can also perform simulations for the purpose of service and testing. We can use the submenus
to check further functions of the device, such as setting parameters, checking diagnostics, and performing maintenance functions. Once we have finished with the devices, we are able to disconnect the bus interface. We can do this by right-clicking on the interface and selecting Disconnect Interface, or by using the Disconnect Interface menu icon at the top of the screen. This concludes the tutorial on how to connect to Communicator using the bus stick.